First bill is Senate 528, bill reported, will be referred to finance by Senator Michelle.
Senator, this is an act to amend the civil rights law in relation to verification of name change. This bill requires the court system to promulgate rules to ensure that persons requesting name changes are not easily forced through the legal process or obligation. The bill requires binding felon offenders and certain other felons to disclose their convictions to court regardless of whether they are incarcerated or under supervision at the time they file a petition for name change. Petitioners must also notify the district attorney and the sentence of court in all counties of conviction.
Is there a motion to enforce?
Yes.
So let me, may I have first, second, and then we'll take I will second the motion with Senator Perkins.
This would require the person to pay a fee?
Well, ultimately, once this goes to the OCA, the mechanism is established. I'm assuming it provides
a payment. And with respect to those who are married or divorced, is that, how does it apply?
I'm sorry?
With respect to name change due to marriage or divorce, how would that apply?
Those name changes don't require that you go to the court. If you have a prior felony conviction, then you may. But if someone who is just getting married, they don't have to go in for any change. But when you are at a previous conviction, then you do to make sure that you are showing that you are eligible to change your name.
Just so I understand, in the context of marriage or divorce, there is no petition to a court. It happens through the process.
Yes.
So none of this would apply.
Any other questions or comments? Any negative votes? Senator Perkins, by recommendation. Bill is reported. Next bill is Senate 541A, and I believe that also is reported and be referred to finance.
Senator, this is an act to amend the criminal procedure law related to the powers of certain federal law enforcement officers. This bill clarifies that federal protective officers, including criminal investigators, law enforcement security officers, and police officers. The purpose is to ensure that these other officers retain their status as peace officers under penal law. The Federal Protective Service and officers from other federal agencies will merge into the Department of Homeland Security in 2003, and the new Federal Protective Service obtained officers with additional titles from other agencies that are set forth in CPL 215.
Is there a motion to report?
So moved.
Senator Gallo, and second, thank you, Senator Hensley, second. Questions or comments? Negative votes? Bill is reported. Our next bill is by Senator Marcelino, and that is Senate 924.
Senator, this is an act to amend the penal law in relation to increasing penalties for first, second, third, and fourth degree stalking. This bill raises the classification for the various degrees of stalking by one degree, such that the lowest level stalking crime will become stalking in the fourth degree, class A misdemeanor, and the highest level stalking crime will become stalking in the first degree, class C felony. Also, any felony stalking crime is defined as a violent felony offense.
Motion to report. Senator Lanza, second by Senator Gallivan. Any questions or comments? Any negative votes? The bill is reported. Next bill is by Senator Golden, Senate 1751.
Senator, this is an act to amend the Civil Rights Law, the Criminal Procedure Law, the Family Court Act, and the Civil Practice Law and rules in relation to protecting the identity of police officers and employees. This bill amends the Civil Rights Law to include within the confidentiality provisions police personnel records that include the identity of undercover police officers, and creates a procedure whereby a district attorney may request that undercover officers' identities be protected. A rebuttable presumption is created that an undercover police officer would be endangered or his or her effectiveness compromised by public disclosure of his or her identity. The bill also allows the district attorney to ask the court for additional measures to protect the police officer's identity if necessary. In addition, the bill requires the court to instruct the jury that no inference previously passed the Senate unopposed in 2005 and 2006.
Is there a motion to report? Senator Harris, second by Senator Ryan. Questions or comments?
I'm going to say it's an excellent bill.
Yours from the Assembly Board and the Janice Holden.
So, very pleased with that. There being no questions or comments, any negative votes? A bill is reported. Our next bill is Senate 2950 by Senator Lane.
Senator, this is an act amending penal law in relation to arson in the first degree. This bill amends the penal law and addresses certain gaps in the provisions of first degree arson, specifically including the use of accelerant that causes a fire or explosion. Such language is necessary because of case law that held that a conviction was not sufficient when such accelerant or was used in the course of a crime. This bill passed the Senate unopposed in 2007 and 2008. And there is a memo in support. No, I'm sorry, that's for 1751.
Is there a motion to report? Moved by Senator Galvin, second by Senator Lanza. Questions or comments? Any negative votes? Bill is reported. Next bill is by Senator Lee Francisco, Senate 4305.
Senator, this is an act on penal law in relation to payment, reparation, and restitution in certain instances. This bill amends the penal law to provide additional judicial discretion for courts of ordering restitution or reparation. The bill authorizes sentencing court to order a convicted offender to make reparation of actual out-of-pocket losses sustained by any entity which took actions to prevent, mitigate, or remedy the damages caused by criminal conduct. This bill passed the Senate unopposed in 2007 and 2008.
Is there a motion to report? Moved by Senator Galvin. Second by Senator Lanza. Questions or comments? Any negative votes? The bill is reported. Our last bill is my bill, Senate 5226.
Senator, this is an act to amend the criminal procedure law, the correction law, the penal law, the arts and cultural affairs law, the general business law, the labor law, the civil practice law, the rules in relation to enacting the Child Sexual Abuse and Exploitation Prevention Act.
Are there any questions? This, incidentally, is a bill which previously introduced by a prior longstanding chair, Senator Holbrook, and we've done some minor adjustments to it. And I think it was the result of hearings that we had held, and it's an effort to deal comprehensively with the subject matter. So, questions or comments? Negative votes? Did you have questions?
No.
Negative votes? The bill is reported.
Without
Representative Burton.